Hello and welcome back to Kelo Dimag Se, presented to you by Dream 11. The last game when we played the fantasy segment, the game was between West Indies and England. Clearly, West Indies didn't have one of the greatest of days. I had Evan Lewis as vice captain as well. The captain worked well for me, Josh Butler. I missed out on Adil Rashid. I expected West Indies to get off to a good start. Clearly, West Indies couldn't get off to a good start, so Adil Rashid came into play a lot more. So, lessons learned from there on, but those type of games don't happen very often. So, the previous game between South Africa and Australia, which I put a fantasy team for, I won the game by 1.5 points against my opponent. So, from the next time, if it is possible, I will give that matchup as well, and we'll talk about the dream team in the next episode for this particular game. We'll be taking a look at the Pakistan versus New Zealand game that's going to happen today. It's taking place at Sharjah. One of the more interesting games as far as this particular group is concerned. Pakistan have won the first game. New Zealand at Sharjah. Not a lot of New Zealand players have been a part of the IPL. Some of them that have been a part of the IPL and played at Sharjah will clearly have the edge. Pakistan have played so much cricket here in this part of the world. PSL has happened a lot more in this part of the world. They've played test cricket here, they've played their national cricket here, so they clearly do have an edge when it comes to understanding the conditions of these pitches here. So Pakistan start the game off with an edge, and New Zealand will definitely have to play at their best to be able to get over Pakistan. But some of the players that have played for New Zealand in this IPL will have a small edge over some of the others that haven't. Tim Seifert was with the KKR team, couldn't get a lot of game time, but was there. Kane Williamson with the SRH side, Tim Saudi was there, the Trent Bolt was there, then Ferguson was there with the KKR side, Mitchell Santner was there with the CSK side. So those are the people that New Zealand will bank upon to really stage a sort of an upset to Pakistan in this particular contest. I'm backing Pakistan to win this game because Pakistan versus New Zealand, and that's exactly why I will go with a 7-4 combination, 7 Pakistani players and 4 New Zealand players. Before I get into the Pakistani side, I will mention who are my 4 players on the New Zealand half of it. Like I said, KKR have some experienced players from the IPL, so I'm going with Tim Seifert, who will be opening the batting with Martin Guptill. Plays a lot of horizontal bat shots, sweeps, reverse sweeps, which will come handy in Sharjah. We also have to make a note of what game has happened at Sharjah. Sri Lanka chased down a score in excess of 170 against Bangladesh. The pitch wasn't keeping low like in some of the IPL games. It was a decent pitch. It was a bit slow, but still Sri Lanka batted beautifully to chase it down. So any score nearing that 170 mark will be a winning score if Pakistan bats first. If New Zealand bat first, they will have to, you know, get somewhere around 155, 160 to try and put some pressure on Pakistan. But this game is going to be a sort of a very important game for the fantasy players in terms of getting their bowlers right. The 4 members of the New Zealand team are people who might come in handy. Trent Bolt is a left-arm fast bowler, has been in the thick of things, has been picking up wickets. So Trent Bolt will again be someone that most of the fantasy players will be picking. So he is there, a part of my side. Jimmy Neesham had a wonderful game for the Mumbai Indians, picked up wickets against the Rajasthan Royals, and in fact I think he cost a lot of people in the fantasy segment that particular night. So Jimmy Neesham is a part of my team. That's one thing that I forgot to mention. He was also a part of the players who played the IPL from the New Zealand contingent, so he will have an advantage compared to some of the other players. Tim Seifert is the keeper that I'm picking. I will be picking Mohammad Rizwan as well. 2 keepers, you can't leave Mohammad Rizwan out. Has been in wonderful form, has had a wonderful game. So he will be the other keeper. So I'm picking 2 keepers for this game. The batters are pretty simple. I'm going with Babar Azam, Kane Williamson already, Fakhar Zaman, and then I'm going with 3 all-rounders. The 3 all-rounders will be Jimmy Neesham, Mohammad Hafiz, and Shadab Khan. Very, very difficult to leave out Shadab Khan too. Fakhar Zaman is someone who didn't get a game last time, but definitely he will bat at Sharjah, and he's been a marquee player for Pakistan when it comes to this format. So those are my picks. The captain for the day, most people will be picking him as the captain of the day, I'm assuming, is Babar Azam. I was very tempted to go for a vice captain towards Mohammad Rizwan, but then finally I said, okay, Kane Williamson is too good a batter, might get to come in a little early as well to bat, which is my expectation. Might happen, might not happen, I'm not sure. So I'm picking Kane Williamson as my vice captain. So that makes it 3 batters, 2 keepers, and 3 all-rounders, which is 8 people that I've already picked. Who am I going for bowlers? It's pretty simple. I've already mentioned New Zealand. I've got Trent Bolt in. Trent Bolt has to be in, and he will be in most cases. I had to make a choice between Hassan Ali and Ferguson, but I'm going with Hassan Ali on purely on form. Pakistan look like a team that's well drilled for these conditions, so I'm going with Hassan Ali. He will be bowling at the death, so you can't miss Hassan Ali out. I think in these conditions, a shortish bowler, Sharjah doesn't have a tendency to bounce a lot, keep the ball low, hit the bottom of the bat, get a few catches around in the deep. So I'm banking on Hassan Ali to pick 3 wickets, maybe 2 will be fine. And then Shaheen Shah Afridi is a lock-in. Everybody will pick Shaheen Shah Afridi. So Shaheen Shah Afridi had a wonderful game against India, bowled beautifully. So he will be the other bowler that I'm picking. So that's my 11 for today's fantasy segment. So a couple of omissions that I've done here is leave Martin Guptill out. The reason I'm leaving Martin Guptill out is I have to leave someone out to balance my side. Otherwise, I'm not able to get the desired 3 bowlers that I'm getting due to point confusion here, because there is going to be some differences in points, so I can't do that. But why Martin Guptill? I had to bank on someone. Martin Guptill comes at a higher cost than Tim Seifert, so I had to leave Martin Guptill out. The reasoning behind also is that he's not been playing in the IPL, hasn't had a lot of games. Yes, he got a 30 against Australia in the practice game. All that is fair enough and great, and I have to leave someone out, so I'm leaving him out. I'm expecting him to probably get out a little early and then bring in maybe Kane Williamson early because he's my vice captain. So those are my expectations. Had to leave someone out between Tim Seifert and Martin Guptill, so I left Martin Guptill out, caught up a bit of points. 0.5 points is the difference, so I used it with the bowlers. The other person that I've omitted is also a bit of an issue. Ferguson, like I said, I was mulling between 3 all-rounders and getting a 4th bowler in. Jimmy Neesham, I had to go with some people from the New Zealand side, so I picked Jimmy Neesham. Shadab Khan is also someone that I would love to pick, a leggy against New Zealanders, so I picked him. Mohammad Hafeez, with the number of left-handers in the New Zealand ranks through the middle order, Devon Conway, Jimmy Neesham and all that, I think he will get his 4 overs in at Sharjah. So I couldn't leave Hafeez out in case Pakistan loses a wicket early. Fakhar Zaman and Hafeez. Hafeez, mind you, is someone that we will definitely have to keep in the side, especially if it's a New Zealand versus Pakistan contest. Mohammad Hafeez in New Zealand recently in the T20I series literally batted like Don Bradman. Never got out. All the games he was making runs in excess of 70 or 80. Finished the games beautifully, so can't leave him out. And that's one of the reasons I had to leave Ferguson out and Guptill out for those points to get the right combination and right people that I wanted in. Hope you enjoyed my team. I'm sure this team of mine is going to give me a victory over my opponent. I'm sure these inputs from me for the conditions and for the teams will help you make your best side. All the very best. Go well today. In Kelo Dimag Se, presented to you by Dream Level.